Now we proceed to peritoneal folds. The peritoneal folds are formed by two layers of peritoneum. Each peritoneal fold contains the following: blood vessels, and lymph nodes. Sympathetic plexus around the blood vessels embedded in the areolar tissue. A specific organ to which the fold is attached. This section showing, this is transverse section, the abdomen, this longitudinal section showing, this is the stomach, this greater omentum, and this is the lesser omentum. This is the spleen, kidney, this is gastrosplenic ligament, and this is lienurenal ligament. Examples of peritoneal folds: the greater omentum is the first one, and the lesser omentum attached to the stomach. Falciform ligament attached to the liver. Gastrosplenic ligament connects the stomach to the spleen. Gastrophrenic ligament connects the stomach to the diaphragm. Lienurenal ligament connects the spleen to the left kidney. Then mesenter of small intestine and the mesocolon attached to small intestine and the large intestine. The broad ligament attached to the uterus. This is again, this example, the stomach, lesser omentum here. This is the mesenter of a small intestine. And this is mesocolon. This is a gastrosplenic ligament. And this is lienurenal ligament. The greater omentum, it is a large fold of peritoneum attached to the greater curvature of the stomach. It lies in front of the intestine and separates it from the anterior abdominal wall. Function of greater omentum: to localize the infection in the peritoneum and prevents its spread. So sometimes it is called bolus man of the abdomen. The contents of the greater omentum, right and left gastroblic vessels, lymph nodes, areolar tissue, and some fats. This is the stomach, lesser omentum. This is the greater omentum. The lesser omentum, it is a fold of peritoneum extends between lesser curvature of the stomach and the porta hepatis of the liver. The right border is free and contains the following: hepatic artery antero and to the left, bile duct antero and to the right, portal vein posterior to both structures. This is the stomach, lesser omentum here, connecting the lesser curvature of the stomach with the porta hepatis of the liver. Peritoneal spaces are many spaces within the peritoneal cavity, and it is the site of collection of fluid or pus. Subphrenic spaces lies between diaphragm and the liver and separated from each other by falciform ligament. Right subhepatic space, sometimes it's called Morrison's pouch or hepatorenal pouch. It is the most dependent part of the peritoneal cavity of the abdomen in the recumbent position. Left subhepatic space, lesser sac, separates the stomach anteriorly from the structure of the stomach bed posteriorly. Rectovesical pouch, Douglas pouch, it lies in the pelvis and it is the most dependent part of the peritoneal cavity in the pelvis. The most dependent parts of peritoneal cavity in the abdomen and pelvis are, number one, Morrison's pouch in the abdomen and Douglas pouch in the pelvis. This is the Douglas pouch here. Sometimes it is called rectouterine or rectovaginal pouch. Peritoneal recesses are small pouches from the peritoneal sac, so it will be of surgical importance because the recess may be the site of internal hernia. Important recess of the peritoneal cavity, number one, superior duodenal recess, lies at the left side of the upper end of the fourth part of the duodenum. Inferior duodenal recess lies at the left side of the lower end of the fourth part of the duodenum. Retroduodenal recess lies behind the third and the fourth parts of the duodenum. Superior ileocecal recess and the inferior ileocecal recess lies at the end of the ileum and the cecum. Retrocecal recess lies behind the cecum. Then recesses of the pelvic mesocolon lies between the two limbs of the pelvic mesocolon. This is some recesses. This is peritoneal recess. There is retrocecal behind the cecum. Blood and nerve supply of the peritoneum. Parietal peritoneum. The same blood supply of the anterior abdominal wall for the anterior part and posterior abdominal wall for the posterior part. Lymphatics join the lymphatics of the body wall. Nerve supply, the parietal peritoneum derived from somatic nerve supplying the covering muscles and the skin of the abdominal wall. Visceral peritoneum and the viscera are derived from the autonomic nerves. So it is not affected by mechanical or thermal stimulation, but affected by traction.